Sulfates are not really all that bad, and it's gonna get very confusing, but let's see if I can break it down easy for you. Hi everyone, it's me, Dr. Ali from HTS Clinic, and today I want to talk to you something very interesting. So I'm passionate about hair, hair transplants, and also your hair care, your general hair health. And I've always been an advocate talking about getting your shampoos that does not have sulfates. So when we talk about sulfates, there's another name for it, or the common name for it is SLS, which you will hear about it a lot. What it stands for is sodium lauryl sulfate. Sometimes it's sodium lauryl sulfate. But there's also newer generation whereby they would use ammonium lauryl sulfate, etc. To make it easy, whenever you buy a shampoo or you want to use a shampoo, just flip it over, look at the ingredients, and look for something that ends with the word sulfate. And you know that that shampoo has sulfate. But what's the big deal about shampoo with sulfates anyway? So when we talk about sulfates in shampoo, let's go check out some common brands. I'm gonna block them out. But if you know your shampoo, you roughly would know which brands that I'm trying to make an example of. I'm not here to tell you whether it's good or it's bad. I am here just to show you how to look for the word sulfates and what kind of shampoo has sulfates. Green color brand here. Yeah, so it's a common shampoo, costs about 15 ringgit, and it is very well advertised. Everybody knows about this. When you look into the ingredients and you look all the way here, it says there's sodium lauryl sulfate. That is one of the contents that's inside. So you know, a 15 ringgit shampoo may have some sulfate. Product 2, right, this is also a very common one. Blue cap, white body, not many brands actually have that. Again, if you look down, it's claimed to be used for especially on scalp issues, dandruffs. And let's see, within the ingredients section, you will also find sodium lauryl sulfate. Now, this is also running between 15 to 20 ringgit. So we have a generalized pattern whereby those 15, 20 ringgit shampoos do contain sulfates. Now, does that mean that expensive shampoos do not have sulfates? Shampoo 3, again, a very classic bottle. This shampoo costs a lot more. It runs in the three figures, 110, 120 ringgit. And again, if you look into the ingredients, it's also got sodium lauryl sulfate. So what's the big deal? This has a good reputation of it being having better ingredients, yet it still contains sulfate. So is sulfate really all that bad? Now, sulfates is a chemical compound that has a main function of becoming a cleansing agent. It's meant for cleaning. It is being used in many different types of cleaning products, from floor cleaners, industrial degreasers, body shampoo or body soap, all the way down to facial product and even your shampoo. High chance, if you have any product that has foam, your product may have sulfates. High chance, right? And that is why a lot of industry players like to put sulfates into their products, because you or us as the consumer, we have been conditioned to know or to feel when there are more foam, we feel cleaner. Have you tried using a shampoo that does not have foam? Tell me how you feel. Comment below in our comment section and let's see what your experience are. But I can tell you quite safely that 9 out of 10 of my patients or the people I meet, they would tell me that if they get a product that has less foam, they tend to feel that it is less clean. And therefore, most products would then give the consumers what they want by putting in sulfates. Now, not all sulfates are bad. Why do I say that? A brand that is going to cost you 110 to 120 ringgit for a bottle of shampoo would have done their research. They would have a name for themselves, and this name does not want to be tarnished, neither are they looking for a lawsuit in case something does happen to them. Yet, they will still use sulfates because it is still the most efficient cleaning product that foams that will give satisfaction and therefore give them the best return of sales. Now, again, I'm saying not all sulfates are bad. From industrial floor cleaner, which is very harsh on the skin but very low cost, to facial products that is very expensive to produce but safe for the skin, you would see there is a very wide difference. Sulfates can be cheap, but sulfates can also be expensive. The only trick is which kind of sulfate that your manufacturer wants to put for you. Now, of course, if you think about it, if you pay peanuts, you're going to get monkey. You get pretty much what you pay for. If you're going to go for a very low entry level shampoo, be prepared if the sulfates are not as great as the top tier ones. All right. So again, that is why you will find sulfates from any kind of shampoo, from the lower end, mid-range to the high end. There will be sulfates. They just use different quality so that they can still get the effect that we need, which is foam and satisfaction. In terms of cleansing, trust me, even shampoos that have no foam can still clean the dirt off you. So what's the effect of sulfates onto your hair? This is something that you probably want to know. Not many people are going to be telling you all about it. Now, when you have sulfates, again, this is mainly for sulfates which are on the lower grade quality, not the higher grade quality. Higher grade quality or the lower concentration ones, you still get your foam, you still get your satisfaction, but you may not get the damage. However, lower cost, higher concentration of sulfates may have a problem onto your hair and scalp. One of the most major problems about having repeated use of sulfates is skin irritation. You may not really see it because you've got hair covering it. However, the most common symptom that starts is itch. You may feel itch on and off throughout the day. The second thing that's going to happen is flakiness of your skin, and it's correlated to symptom number one. When you itch, you start to scratch. And the more you scratch, the more you agitate the skin, the more you're going to get flakiness of your scalp. This flakiness is very much misunderstood as dandruff. It's easier for us to think about it as an allergic reaction onto our skin. You may or may not have seen people who have allergic reaction. The common symptoms are redness and flakiness of the skin. On the body, we call it eczema. On the scalp, we call it dandruff, a fancy name for it. But the real problem is an allergy towards a chemical compound, and frequently, it's sulfates. So there you go. Having sulfates in your shampoo, if it's at low concentration, you probably may not get much problem. On higher concentration, whereby it's closer to floor cleaning grades or industrial cleaning grade, you're gonna get skin irritation, itch, and flakiness. And that is why I advocate for using better sulfates, or to make life even easier, perhaps no sulfates at all. Hey guys, before we move on to the next section, do me a favor, hit the subscribe button, like the content, maybe post some comments if you're using any of this product or any other products that you're using that you'd like to share with us your experience. If there's sulfates inside, just drop me a line. Now, having said such, of course, I would also like to introduce shampoos that have no sulfates so that you have a rough guide, an easy guide, one of which, also a slightly on higher end brand, it's a bit more difficult to look for the lower ones, which does not contain sulfates. This bottle of shampoo would cost somewhere in the range of 120 to 140 ringgit for the smaller ones, up to about almost 180 to 200 ringgit for the larger bottles. But there will be no sulfate contents within. If you're going to be using it, there will be foam. However, the foam may not be as luscious as much as the other brands. One of the tricks that you could do is you double cleanse yourself. First round of shampoo, just to remove the dirt and grime. Second round, just small amounts will be sufficient to generate the foam that's already onto your clean hair. One more that is available, of course, would be community shampoo. Again, has got no sulfates within, safe for your skin. These are just some of the many alternatives. The onus is on us as consumers to turn the bottle around and have a look at the ingredients so that you know what you're going to be using onto your hair. If it's something that you can accept, great. But if it's something that you want safety, then look for one which does not have sulfate. So, at the end of the day, are sulfates bad? Not necessary. Why are sulfates still there? It's for foam, to make you feel clean. How do we pick a good sulfate? Pretty much price guided, pretty much. Price and brand guided. What are your alternatives if you're not sure? Because really they don't tell you what's the content of sulfates that they're using for their shampoo, then pick one which has no sulfate. I hope you found this guide useful, and please subscribe, like, share the content so that I can make extra, more informative content that will help you guide your hair health and your hair care.